Hi guys, welcome. This is another episode of Come Jam With Me, Sebastian. So today I decided to make some grilled oven chicken, some rice and peas, and also some carrot juice with salad. And this is how I prep my chicken to start. So I wash my chicken thoroughly with lemon to subtract the rawness and also any bacteria lingering in my meat. So after thoroughly washing my chicken, I then dice my chicken in proper precise portion that I like or preferred. Now it's time to season my chicken. I'm a person that likes a lot of seasoning, plenty seasoning. I normally measure my seasoning with a tablespoon. As my mama always said, a tablespoon of salt, a tablespoon of all-purpose, a tablespoon of every little thing. I like using pimento and garlic when cooking, so here goes a little pimento seed to get the meat well spicy during cooked. And again, I like using a lot of seasoning when I'm cooking, sometimes a bit too much, but it always tastes good. A little soy sauce, not too much, just to get the color right when cooking. Now there you go, my chicken well seasoned and ready for the oven. But let me cover this a bit and check on my peas. Now as you can see, my peas is boiling with some few pegs of garlic, and there's go my carrot and my vanilla, my sweet milk, my nutmeg, and I'm gonna prep my carrot juice. So now I begin to scrape the excess skin from the carrot because I don't want to peel it to chop into the carrot. Growing up, I used to love my carrot juice. My mom did not make carrot juice often, but when she does, it was like a treat, a special Sunday, like an Easter Sunday or a Christmas day or a special birthday. She'd make carrot juice and it would always taste so nice, and this is how she made it. So after peeling my carrot, dice my carrot, and then blend my carrot with whole milk. So I then strain my carrot to get rid of the excess bits, because I'm making this carrot without the bits in it. And then if it's not properly strained, I'll strain it again and again until I eradicate all the bits. And that's how my carrot juice looks. Now I'm gonna add the flavors like my vanilla essence, and I'm gonna sweeten it with my sweet milk, and also my ground nutmeg, another provision, just to get the right kick. Now I'm adding a bit of salt just to stop any tummy ache. I've got such a heavy hand, but in all in all, it tastes really good. Now it's time for my sweet milk and some grated nothing egg, or whatever it's called. Now there you have it, a big jar of carrot juice. Looks so good. Now let me try some. Oh fucking hell, that tastes so good, just like I planned. Now it's time to prep my tray for the oven to get my chicken in the oven. I add some butter to the tray to stop my meat from sticking to the tray itself. And there's my ground provision, my scallion, my tomato, my garlic, my spring onion, my sweet pepper. After packing the tray, I'm going to wrap my tray with some foil paper and get it ready to put in the oven for like about 15 to 20 minutes on a low cooked oven. A lot of people often ask if I'm a chef. No, I'm not a chef. Whenever I'm feeling hungry or anything like that, I imagine what I'm going to eat first and then I try to cook it exactly how I imagine it. Now I think my peas is ready, so now it's time to add my coconut milk. No, I'm not grating no coconut, that's the thing, is long, it's dead. So yeah, I add my coconut milk. Making sure all the peas are properly soaked in the coconut milk before I add in my ground provision. Now it's time to add my seasoning, my spice and my herbs to the rice. A little bit of all-purpose to my rice pot to give it a little bit of taste. Now it's time to wash my rice, and this is how I wash my rice. Now it's time to make my sauce for my barbecue jerk grilled chicken. Yeah, barbecue jerk grilled chicken, you heard me right? I like adding ketchup, tomato ketchup, to my sauce or spice whenever time I'm making gravy or anything like that. It give it that rich, authentic look. And a bit of sugar also give my chicken that sweet taste when it's baking. And this is my sauce. Look how thick and nice and rich it looks. And there's my rice and peas. I'll simmer down. Turn the fire on low, and that's my baked chicken. Yep, steam up, everything ready now. It's time to add my sauce to my baked chicken. And there you have it. I'm gonna put back my chicken back in the oven for another 5 to 8 minutes, 10 minutes max. In the meantime, let me check on my rice. How it's coming on. Wah, looking good, Sebastian. Wah, rice Shelly, look at that. Wah. And if you ask me why I put the plastic bag over my rice, I don't know, it's a Jamaican thing, I guess. I don't know, I really don't know. I see my mom do it, so I just do it. But look at that. Now it's time to check out my chicken. 5-10 minutes over now. Wow. Wow. I could smell all the herbs and the spice and the flavor in my chicken. Look at my chicken. It looks so rich and so vibrant. And there you have it. And another episode of Come Nyam with Sebastian. My carrot juice, my rice and peas, my baked grilled chicken, my salad. Wow, I can't wait to dig in, guys. This is so amazing. It tastes good, everything looks good, everything looks fine, well prepared, and well prepared for a king. And this is how I treat myself on a normal day. I cooked, I think about it, I think how I want to cook it, think how I want to prepare it, and then I think how I want to eat it, and then present it to myself the way, just as how I think it should be. Look at that. On another episode, I've come near with Chipsy, Sebastian, mad thing.